Hello and welcome to realityfuturestrading.com. In today's video, I'm going to be going over hotkeys, the benefits of hotkeys, the use of hotkeys, as well as the one hazard of hotkeys that everybody should know. Also, I'm going to be going over a special tool that I use that makes the use of hotkeys even easier. Well, as we know with NinjaTrader, it's pretty easy to place an order here on our chart. There's so many different ways to do it. We can either use a depth of market or a dome, as we have over here, or we can use ChartTrader. I prefer to use ChartTrader myself. Now, there's different ways to do it, just like I said. We can buy market, sell market, buy the ask, sell the ask, buy the bid, sell the bid, and so forth. Also, what we can do with ChartTrader is we can right-click, we can scroll down, and we can place orders that way. We could place a sell stop. We can place a buy stop. Or if we want, we can just use a good old-fashioned limit order to go ahead and buy the market. Couple of different ways to get out of the trades as well. Let's say I want to buy limit right here, but I want to scrub this trade. There's two different ways to do it. I can either close the trade by pressing the close button up here, or if I like, I can right click on my chart trader over here, and then I can go to where it says flatten everything. Now, if I flatten everything, this flattens every position that I have on NinjaTrader. So I'll go ahead and I'm going to hit flatten everything.
Order canceled.
All right, now I know everything is completely clear. Now I'm real big on time, and the primary way that I enter the market is with a market order. So I want the fastest possible way for me to get into the market. So what I do is I use a thing called hotkeys. And NinjaTrader comes standard with hotkeys. To find your hotkeys, all you've got to do is go to Tools in your Control Center, come down to the Hotkey Manager. And what you're going to see here is you're going to see all these different little codes here of buttons on your keyboard that you can press to get different indicators. I've got a hotkey set up for flatten everything. For my order entry, I have hotkeys set up for buy market, sell market, and I also have a hotkey set up for break even ATM strategy. Every time you click OK, it's going to let you know that all hotkeys are inactive when a modal form has focus, meaning when any window is popped up, such as this one right here, your hotkeys should be inactive. So you click OK, and then it goes away. Now the next thing that I want to do is I actually want to cover how to set a hotkey up. So once again, we're going to go to Tools. We're going to go to Hotkey Manager. And let's go ahead and set one up in order entry. Let's say we want to set one up here for buying the ask. That's the highlighted blue bar we see right here, buy ask. Then you're going to get a drop down. Go ahead and drop down, and then let's go ahead and let's see if we can pick some keys. Let's say Control Shift. Let's see if Control Shift B does anything for us. We click OK. There we have it. Let's OK this. OK. Now, on our keyboard, when we want to buy the bid, all we're going to do is we're going to do Control Shift B. Well, there it is right there. Now, once again, now I really don't want to be in this trade, of course, so I'm just going to close this trade out.
Order target.
The next thing that I'm going to do for hotkeys, and I'll show you how they're really handy. Let's go into the Hotkey Manager and let's just look at the chart and let's see what we have available. As you can see here, there's an entire list of functions that your hotkeys will provide. So let's do a a Fibonacci retracement. In order to get a Fibonacci retracement, there's two different ways we can do it. Now, let's remember the Fib retracement is F8 on our keyboard. So we're going to click OK. Now, there's two ways to get a Fibonacci retracement. We can either get it from our drawing tools, which works, but again, for me, it's a little time consuming, or we can go to our keyboard and just click F8. And there we have it. In order to make your hotkeys work, you can set all this stuff up, and if you don't do this step, none of your hotkeys will work. What we do to do that is we go into Tools, we go into Options, and then we have to check the box Order Entry Hotkeys right here. You check that box, you click OK, and then you're good to go. As I said earlier, I use a special tool for my hotkeys. I use the Logitech G13 Advanced Game Board. And yes, I said game board. I use this as an alternative to a dealer desk keyboard like they would use on a trade desk. A little bit more affordable, and this is also, it's very, very easy to program. I provided some links in my blog where you can get this tool, and I'm going to show you how easy it is to actually program this particular tool. Now, once you've purchased a Logitech G13 and uploaded the software, you're going to be able to get a little keypad that's just like this. Any of these things that you see that have a letter attached to them have not been assigned a hotkey yet. So let's take a look at my G4 button. It's available right now. And all I've got to do to program a hotkey is click this button. Now, I don't have a Fibonacci retracement tool on here, so I'm going to go ahead and add it. I've clicked my button, and now I need to go one step down and assign a keystroke. All I need to do for that is touch my keyboard where it says F8, and I click OK, and it's now in there. So let's close that out and let's see how it works. When I want my Fibonacci retracement tool, all I've got to do is left-click the chart, hit the G4 button, and there's my Fibonacci retracement tool right there. Nice and handy. All right, well, now I've shown you how you can use hotkeys with your keyboard right on your desktop, or you can use them with a Logitech G13. I prefer the G13 as it's just much easier, it's much quicker, and in a case with, say, my Buy Market button, the hotkey for that, I have Control-Alt-B set up. So rather than having to go Control-Alt-B on the keyboard, I actually have one button that I need to press, which is right here on my keypad, and then I can go ahead and I can buy market. Now over here, I've also got Flatten My Account programmed in for my thumb buttons here. And then I've got break-even strategy on my little toggle switch that's on my keypad as well. The one hazard that I need to discuss with hotkeys is, I'll tell you, they're great for getting orders in quick, bringing up a drawing tool quick, placing markers, and so on and so forth. However, the biggest hazard to using hotkeys, particularly if you're using a Logitech G13 keypad, is if you own a cat and the cat steps on that button while you're out of your office, you just placed a trade. If you use hotkeys, be very, very careful, and it's also easy to fat finger a trade when you're using a Logitech G13. Now, it's not a loaded gun, but you just need to be careful with it. What I suggest is this. Each one of these modes here, M1, M2, and M3, each one of these is literally like having a completely different keypad at your fingertips. What I suggest is, and what I do, is in the case of M2, These are just drawing tools right down here. There is no way to place an order. When I leave my office, I reach up and this button is on the G13. I press M2, the display goes white and I know I'm safe. Well, I hope that you've enjoyed this video and I hope you found it informative and helpful. If you have any questions, please leave me a comment in the blog or you can email me at ray@realityfuturestrading.com. Thanks and have a great day.